everyone. In this video, we are going to start chapter 3 decimals, exercise 3.1. The statement of first sum is expressed in rupees. It's consisting of two subparts, A and B part, to which we have to be converted into rupees. So before starting the first part, solution of first part, that is 17 paise, let us understand about the conversion of rupee into paisa. As we all know that rupee 1, that is equals to what? 100 paise. Okay, as we all know that 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise, and 1 paisa, that will be equals to what? That will be equals to rupees 1 upon 100. Okay, this we have to be keep in mind whenever we are using the conversion of rupees into paisa or paisa into rupees. Here, out of rupees and paisa, which term is the smallest one? Paisa is the smallest term as comparative to rupees. When smallest term we have to convert into the bigger term, so we use to divide. Okay, so here as we all know that 1 rupee is equals to 100 paisa, 1 paisa is equals to rupees 1 upon 100, then 17 paisa will be equals to what? 17 divided by 100. Okay, why we are dividing with 100? Because here we are converting the smallest term into the biggest term. So this can be written as rupees 0.17. Okay. How I am writing this? As you can see here in the denominator, two zeros are given. So in the numerator, we will leave two digits before after writing the decimal. So here two zeros are given to us. So we left two digits, 7 and 1, and then place a decimal and write a zero in it, in front of it. So this is converted into rupees 0.17. This is the solution of first part. First sum, first part. Okay. Now in the B part, what we have to do? We have to convert 55 rupees and 55 paise into paise, into rupees only. Okay. So it is already given us in as a 55 rupees. So plus what we have to do, we have to convert this 55 paise into rupees. So as we have done 17 paise, here also what we are going to do, 55 divided by 100. So this paise is converted into rupees. Why? The reason will be same as in the above question. Rupees 1 is equals to 100 paise. Therefore, 1 paisa will be equals to what? 1 paisa will be equals to rupees 1 upon 100. So whenever we are dividing the given paise into 100, the unit will be converted into rupees. So we can write rupees over here. So this can be written as 55 plus 0.2 zeros are there. We will leave two digits and then place a decimal over here. So this will be equals to 0.55. Okay. And this rupees, this is already given as a rupees. So we will take rupees out. Now this we have to be add two terms. Now this term is consisting of a decimal, but here decimal is not there. Then how we can add them? 55, because decimal is not given. So we will write decimal. Afterwards we will place two zeros over here. And with what we have to add? 0.55. So decimal ke niche decimal aa jayega. 5, 5. And here we will write 00 and will add them. So after adding, the answer will be equals to 55.55. Okay. We will add from the left side, right side only. 0 plus 5, 5. 0 plus 5, 5. Then decimal 5 plus 0, 5. 5 plus 5. Okay. So answer, required answer will be equals to what? 55.55 rupees is the required answer of the first sum B part. Okay. Students, now we are going to start second sum. Second sum is quite similar as the first sum. The statement is convert the following smaller unit to bigger units. Okay, smaller unit we have to convert into the bigger unit. In the second sum, four subparts are given to us. Out of four subparts, one part, first part I am going to solve for you, and remaining you will solve by yourself because it is quite similar. Okay, so here the smallest unit is what? Centimeter. Into meter we have to convert. So smaller unit we have to convert into bigger unit. What I told you in the previous term, when we have to convert the smaller unit into the bigger term, we use to divide with the number. Okay, so what is the relation between meter and centimeter? We all know that 1 meter is equals to what? 100 centimeter. Okay, so therefore what we are going to use over here, we have to convert centimeter into meter. and what is the relation between them? 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So here what I will do, I will write this 25 centimeter as 25 upon 100. So here the two zeros are given us in the denominator. So in the numerator we will leave two digits and we'll place a decimal over here. So 0.25 meter is the required answer of second sum A part. Okay. And the remaining B, C, D part is given to us. They are quite similar as the first sum and second sum A part. The thing that you have to be keep in mind is only that the conversion of unit. Here we have written 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. Okay. And one more formula that you have to be keep in mind is that 1 centimeter that is equals to what? 10 millimeter. Okay. One of this formula you will use over here. Second, we have used that 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter and 1 meter that is equals to what? 100 centimeter that we have already used in the A part also. And the next formula, 1 kilometer that is equals to what? 1000 meter. So these three formulas that you have to be used in second sum and all the subparts are solvable by you. Okay. Students, similarly, we can solve the third sum. Third sum is quite similar as the second sum. The only difference is the difference of unit. Here, we have given the statement of third sum as expressed in kilograms. Here also, two subparts are given to us, A and B part. A part I am going to solve for you. B part you will solve yourself. Okay. Third sum A part is 39 gram into kilograms. 39 gram we have to convert into kilogram. So here also you have to be keep the units in the mind. What are that? 1 kilogram that is equals to what? 1000 gram. Okay. So this formula you have to be keep in the mind to solve this sum. Again, the smaller unit is converted into the bigger unit. Whenever we are used to convert the smaller unit into the bigger unit, we used to divide. So now this is given as 39 grams. So this can be written as 39 divided by what? How many grams are there in 1 kilogram? 1000. So we will divide this term by 1000. So this can be written as 39 upon 1000 kilogram. Okay. So here, now you can see here three zeros are given to us, but here only two digits are given as 9, 3. Okay, but third digit is not there. So I will write a zero over here. Then I will write a decimal and after that I will write a zero. Okay, so this number can be written as 0.039 kilogram. That is the conversion of 39 gram. So the 39 gram in kilograms can be written as 0.039. Okay, so B part of the third sum you can solve yourself by using this conversion. So this is the required answer of third sum A part.